Direct from Southern California, the car capital of the world, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the Los Angeles Auto Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Steve Cannon, President and CEO, Mercedes-Benz USA.
So good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our press conference. You know, as you can see here from the video, it's been an amazing year, really a record year for us at Mercedes-Benz, and we're just getting started with the biggest product offensive in our company's history. So let's start at the upper end with our all-new S-Class. So those of you who are in Frankfurt probably remember seeing some of the big plans that we've got for the S-Class. Well, folks, those plans start now. Today you're going to see our S-Class for adrenaline junkies. That's the S63 AMG. Next year, you'll see what is perhaps the most beautiful S-Class we've ever produced, the S-Class Coupe. And then our most efficient S-Class in the form of a plug-in hybrid, which is coming in early 2015. You know, the S-Class was designed with one simple goal, to be the best car in the world. And so far from the feedback that we've gotten, we believe we've absolutely accomplished that mission. And our customers are really confirming that for us. We've received more than 300,000 orders worldwide, and that's even before the introduction here in the United States and in China. So here in the U.S., just after a few weeks in the market, the S-Class sales are up 75%. And starting this month, another S-Class is going to help to accelerate that momentum. Ladies and gentlemen, the S63 AMG is making its US premiere right now and will soon be in showrooms. Thanks to comprehensive use of aluminum and carbon fiber, the S63 is now about 100 pounds lighter, and it's got 577 horsepower, so it's more powerful than its predecessor. And the new S63 offers for the first time an enhanced 4MATIC system. And this system directs 67% of the available power to the rear wheel, and it can launch the S63 from 0 to 60 in an incredible 3.9 seconds. Folks, that's faster than a Porsche 911 Carrera S. But we didn't stop there. Starting next year, our customers will now have another S-Class model to choose from. And we think it is the absolute pinnacle of exclusivity and refinement. Let's take a look. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the ultimate combination of luxury and driving performance. The 2015 Mercedes S65 AMG. It's proof that absolute power can corrupt absolutely, but I think in a very good way. Let's take a look at the specs. It's a 6-liter twin-turbo V12 with 621 horsepower and an incredible 738 feet-pound of torque. And while those specs might be impressive, today's performance isn't just about horsepower. It isn't just about acceleration. It's also about minimizing the impact that a car has on the environment. So we've engineered our V12 to meet the strictest emission standards in the world, such as EU6. To save weight, a new lithium-ion battery system replaces both the starter and the backup batteries, just like the S63. And our new AMG 7-speed transmission will help reduce consumption while increasing driving dynamics. This is the first time that it's been paired with the V12 engine in the S-Class. The 2015 S65 is going to arrive here in the United States in the spring. So before our next reveal, let me fill you in on a few performance statistics for Mercedes-Benz USA, because we are having the best year in our history. We're on track to sell more than 300,000 units, the first time ever. Sales are up so far year to date 14%. We're growing faster than the general market, we're growing faster than the luxury market, and year to date, Mercedes-Benz is the number one luxury brand in the United States. We're seeing some of the highest market share that we've seen in our history, 17%. That means that fully one in every five cars on luxury cars sold today is a Mercedes-Benz. Now, these amazing results, they come from a great team, they come from the best dealers in the industry, and an incredible product pipeline. And each and every one of those new models is going to play its part in taking the Mercedes-Benz brand to a new place. Think about this. The CLA, which we just launched 2 months ago, has absolutely delivered on its promise of bringing new buyers into our brand. Our early data indicates that the CLA conquest rate is 70%, and that number is rising. So you combine that with the highest loyalty rate in the industry, and that just means that when we get customers into our brand, we don't lose them. And now we're going to build on that momentum with the all-new GLA that's coming next year. Let's have a look. So the GLA, like its sibling, the CLA, is going to play a key role in our growth strategy. Experts predict that the sporty crossover segment is poised to grow significantly by almost 1 million units to a worldwide segment of 2.6 million vehicles. Here in the United States, that segment is poised to grow just as dramatically. When the GLA arrives in the fall of next year, it's going to stand out because of design, styling, and versatility. We expect it's going to appeal to younger buyers who want to indulge their appetite for style and their appetite for adventure. The GLA is going to offer a turbocharged 2-liter four-cylinder engine that's going to produce 208 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque. And then there's that aggressive styling, which is, I think, one of the features of the GLA that is absolutely going to make it stand apart from its competition. But I'm going to let that discussion be led by our chief of design, Gordon Wagner. So Gordon, could you come up and join me? Take it away.
Thank you, Steve. Hello and welcome, everybody. It's great to be here. It's great to be in LA. What I love about this city is that it keeps reinventing itself. And that is only one aspect LA and Mercedes have in common. Actually, shaping this balance between tradition and progression is one of the major tasks of the Mercedes-Benz design team. Our new GLA is a perfect example of how we transfer the myth of our brand into the future and so define a modern luxury that invites the next generation of Mercedes-Benz customers to begin their love affair with our brand. With its striking features and off-road proportions, the GLA expresses our progressive thinking. We have managed to combine as much emotional appeal as possible with much purity as necessary. The GLA embodies all of our SUV genes, but in a very sporty, stylish, and expressive way. It features a low greenhouse, raised vehicle body, and large wheel arches. Shows clearly defined surfaces and sculptured contours of the vehicle body. The progressiveness also shows in the interior, which represents a modern luxury as well, with a wide range and combination of high-quality materials, a free-floating flat screen with a high-gloss display, and a driver-oriented sporty cockpit. In a nutshell, we have created the SUV of the future. One look tells you how much fun it is to drive. While speaking of fun while driving, it is also possible to experience a Mercedes without a driver's license. But don't worry, I'm not suggesting anything illegal here. Instead, I only need to say two words that quickens the pulse of car lovers and gamers alike. Gran Turismo. There's no doubt about it. Over the past 15 years, Gran Turismo has changed the world of virtual driving in ways nobody could have foreseen. And it's a great pleasure to have the mastermind behind this development here with us today. Welcome, Kazunori Yamaguchi. Now, it's still a couple of weeks until the release of the new Gran Turismo version. But if you ask me, the greatest sight of this game is waiting for you right now. Ladies and gentlemen, with its extreme proportions and aggressive appearance, the Mercedes-Benz AMG Vision Gran Turismo embodies our design philosophy of central purity in a distinctive and fascinating way. It embodies such a sense of acceleration, it looks fast just sitting still. Let me quickly point out a few highlights. Typical Mercedes-Benz sports car GT proportion with a long, long hood, cap positioned far back, and wheels as high as the body. It has the highest precision technical details in contrast to the central form of the vehicle body. It features a grille inspired by the very first SL Panamericana, while the rear shows 8 exhaust pipes with a taillight bar running through them. Ladies and gentlemen, continuously reinventing this brand's greatest racing heritage makes Mercedes-Benz performance very much at home on the real roads around the globe. And with that, I would like to hand the floor back over to Steve. Thank you very much.
Gordon, nice job. Gordon. All I can say, Gordon, is wow. please keep doing exactly what you're doing. I think you'll agree that there's something very different taking place out of our design area. It's fresh, it's bold, it's different. It's great styling, obviously, that's very important, but it's also what's under the hood that counts just as much at Mercedes-Benz, and I don't think anyone knows that better than our brand new head of AMG, Tobias Merz. You know, I think he's the perfect combination of development engineer, he's a bit of a speed demon himself, and he's also part mad scientist. So I think this makes him the perfect guy to head AMG. So please welcome AMG Chairman and CEO, Tobias Merz.
Thank you for introducing me on a very personal way. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my first auto show as head of Mercedes-AMG. And I'm really excited it is here in Los Angeles. To a designer like Gordon, LA is a city of style. For a guy like me, it's home to lots of AMGs and some of my favorite driving roads. And here is our interpretation of the new sporty SUV, the concept GLA 45 AMG. And believe me, it's very close to the production model coming next year. Let's review some of the highlights. Aggressive AMG styling elements boost the GLA's spectacular design. AMG 4MATIC, all-wheel drive combined with a specially engineered chassis, sets new standards for driving dynamics. And most important, the concept GLA 45 AMG comes with the world's most powerful four-cylinder engine, 355 horsepower, and a maximum torque of 332 foot-pounds allow this baby to go from 0 to 60 in under 5 seconds. As you can see, this car has the power and the discipline of a true athlete. I have no doubt that it will become a common sight here in the US. After all, US is our most important market for AMG. That's why this is the perfect time for me to talk about the future goals of the Mercedes-Benz performance brand. As you know, AMG has always been about more of everything. And the same goes for our strategy. Precisely, we will expand our lineup to 30 models, increase our annual sales to more than 30,000 units worldwide by 2017, and continue to set new standards for both performance and efficiency. And when it comes to performance, there is one car that has come to symbolize this more than any other, the modern interpretation of the legendary Gullwing. Presented in 2009, the SLS AMG established itself as both a brand shaper and an automotive icon. And within a short time, we created a family of models, including a Roadster, the SLS GT with enhanced driving dynamics, a Black Series model, which has the most powerful V8 engine in the history of Mercedes-AMG, a successful GT3 race car with over 110 victories since 2011, and an electric drive version, the world's most powerful electric super sports car in series production. To summarize, with the SLS, we have written an extraordinary success story. And now, we will write its last chapter. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the SLS AMG GT Final Edition. Only 4 years after its public debut, the SLS-AMG is already a classic. And here you can see that this amazing car will say goodbye in style. With 583 horsepower and the ultimate exclusivity in terms of design and equipment, the list of highlights includes an expressive exterior with a unique carbon fiber hood and special AMG forged wheels. Inside, the GT Final Edition features an interior with upholstery in black Designio Napa leather and an AMG performance steering wheel wrapped in Alcantara. In fact, this masterpiece is just exclusive as it looks. We will build only 350 units of the SLS GT Final Edition. So if you want to get one, you should sign up as soon as possible. I'd also like to stress that there won't be a direct successor of the SLS AMG. Instead, we plan to present a new AMG sports car next year, and it will challenge in a segment where we haven't been before. I think this silhouette tells you a lot already. This car will be a real force in the market. Just with my colleagues, I'm very excited about it. And the same is true for the future of Mercedes-AMG. I look forward to sharing more details on both in the new future. And with that, I'd like to invite Steve up one more time.
Thanks. Thank you. Good work. All right, folks, we're bringing this to a close. I think you can probably have a sense now that we're taking this brand to all new places, both in terms of volume and a commitment to leave nothing on the table when it comes to new and viable segments in the luxury space. That's why we'll be launching 30 new products in the next 7 years, an average of one new model every quarter, all the way from 2013 to 2020. So you can plan on seeing a lot more from us in the near future. So I'd like to thank you all for joining us, and if I could get Gordon and Tobias up here for one last final shot. And folks, have a great LA Auto Show. Thank you, take care.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.